House Republicans take up the president's call to protect the unborn. They're working to force a vote on a bill to protect babies who survive abortion. And they're using two procedural moves to do that. Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi tells us how. Good evening, Jason.
Good evening, Lauren. One path is Minority Leader Kevin McCarthy today calling for unanimous consent for the House floor to pick up the Born Alive Abortion Survivor Protection Act. But that move wasn't approved by Democratic leaders, so it didn't work. Now, the GOP's second strategy is campaigning to get the needed 218 lawmaker signatures, which would, in fact, then bring the bill up for an immediate vote. And they got new motivation last night.
Who can feel pain in a mother's womb?
The reactions inside the House chamber as the president devotes 2 minutes of his speech to tackling abortion. Right after the speech, we spoke with Catholic Congressman Chris Smith.
He did the cause of life a very significant help by being so profound in his statement, so clear. Ultrasound has shattered the myth that an unborn child is anything but human and alive, a person.
The president challenged Congress to pass a bill to ban late-term abortion.
A child not only knows the sound of her mother's voice, but can feel pain. And to kill a child in the womb at that age and that stage in life is unconscionable.
Catholic Congresswoman Ann Wagner is also the lead sponsor of the House's bill to require abortion doctors and nurses treat a baby who survives an abortion. Her new push for that bill today comes after New York approved a law allowing abortions up till birth. And Virginia's governor was accused of supporting infanticide, both condemned last night by President Trump.
He clearly stated a principle of human dignity and justice in a manner that confronted the grossness of what the governor of Virginia and New York has done.
But Catholic Democrat Henry Cuellar, who in the past voted for the Born Alive bill, sees an uphill battle.
He said, I want some legislation passed. I think if he looks at the House, you know it's not going to happen.
The Senate shot down that bill, the 20-week abortion ban, which President Trump promoted. It failed in January. Democratic leader Chuck Schumer wasn't impressed in the president's speech. He accused Trump of giving a divisive and at times nasty speech. Lauren?
Capitol Hill correspondent Jason Calvi. Thank you, Jason.